Islam and Christianity, Part 1, Preface. We begin to write the book Islam and Christianity with the Basmala. All praise be to Allahu Ta'ala, and may the best of prayers be upon his beloved Prophet, Muhammad alayhi salam, upon his Ahlul Bayt, and all his companions. Allahu Ta'ala has created everything, the living and the non-living, out of nothing. He alone is the creator. Because he pities mankind very much, he creates and sends everything that is necessary for a comfortable, sweet, and cheerful existence in this world and the next. As the most superior and valuable of his endless blessings, he has made distinctions for us between the way of truth leading to felicity and the way of falsehood, which brings about trouble and sorrow. He has always commanded goodness, diligence, and to be helpful to others. He has declared that he will call all people to account following the rising after death, that those who do good deeds will live in endless happiness in paradise, and that those who do not believe in the teachings of his prophets, alayhim salam, will remain in endless torture and pain in hell. Therefore, we begin writing this work glorifying his name and consigning ourselves to his guidance. We also see it as an honorable duty upon us to express our gratitude and love for those superior men called prophets, especially for the most superior of them, the last prophet, Muhammad alayhi salam, whom he has selected as an intermediary and messenger to reveal the way of felicity and comfort to human beings. This book is written in the nature of a key for those Muslim brothers of ours who have just a smattering of knowledge on how the Islamic religion has developed, and it has been written for those non-Muslims willing to know the fundamentals of Islam. Islam, the most up-to-date and the most immaculate of the world's existing religions, is based upon very humane and very logical principles. Without going into details, this book touches upon the fundamentals of Islam and makes a comparison of Islam with other religions. It answers criticisms raised against Islam by its adversaries and explains as compendiously as possible the qualifications essential for being a good Muslim. For those who would like to read valuable books on Islam written by Islamic scholars, rahimahumullahu ta'ala, after learning the facts contained in this book, we advise that they read books published in different languages by the Hakikat Kitabevi or bookstore in Istanbul. The names of these books are appended to our books. Read this book slowly and with reflection. Encourage others to read it too. An ignorant person cannot be a good Muslim. Indeed, it is impossible for a person not to attach all his heart to Islam after learning its fundamentals. After reading this book, you will also realize what a lofty, sacred, logical, and perfect religion Islam is, and you will attach all your heart and soul to it in order to attain salvation and repose in this world and in the hereafter. Publisher's note. Anyone who wishes to print this book in its original form or to translate it into any other language is granted beforehand our permission to do so. And people who undertake this beneficial feat are accredited to the benedictions that we in advance offer to Allahu Ta'ala in their name, and also our best wishes of gratitude, and we thank them very much. However, permission is subject to the condition that the paper used in printing be of good quality and that the design of the text and setting be properly and neatly done without mistakes. A warning. Missionaries are striving to advertise Christianity. Jews are working to spread the concocted words of Jewish rabbis. Hakikat Kitabevi bookstore in Istanbul is struggling to publicize Islam, and Freemasons are trying to annihilate religions. A person with wisdom, knowledge, and conscience will identify and adopt the right one among these alternatives, and will help to spread the wisest of these choices for salvation of all humanity. Nothing, nor any other way, could be better or more valuable, inasmuch as one's aim is to serve humanity.